Masters, this little Monster Go Desi coming at ya. And today I'm going to not exactly redesign my little monster Sona, but at least edit her design. While there's nothing that I hate about the old design, I just felt like it was time to kind of upgrade it from what it used to be. This is actually a design that I've been using since high school. So for nearly a decade, I've had my monster Sona with a sharp contrast between black and white and a bright color. And while, yeah, this does work and looks good, I feel like it's become a little bit too simple and basic. And not very much like the skinwalker that I want her to be portrayed as. So, let's get started. Right, to start off with, I wanted to explain that my character Calliope, who I've had ever since high school, was meant to be a mix between different kinds of creatures. Even though she kind of just ended up looking like a cat overall. And over time, I have taken different personality tests to see what kind of animal I am. So for this, I decided to use the three animals that suit me most and use them to put together a new design for Calliope. Since she's a skinwalker, it's obvious that she's supposed to be a mix of different animals from my skinwalker video. And while, yeah, characters like Blue only have one animal pelt to transform with, I still really liked Calliope's overall design, but I wanted to switch it up a bit. So for this, I'll be using a common house cat, a river otter, and finally a paint horse. I thought that these three animals would help not only suit Calliope, but make the design a little bit more interesting, even if it doesn't have a drastic change. If you've been following me for a while, you'd probably notice that a lot of the times when I don't draw my persona as my monster Sona, I'll sometimes draw me with a black eye with something leaking out of it. Or other times in my comics, you'll see a little slime creature on my shoulder talking to me. And in my earlier videos, my monster Sona would be somewhere in the video, but would mostly be there for comedic effect. This is because in high school, I was going through a pretty deep depression. And whenever I would see somebody draw their depression as a physical thing, like a little monster on the shoulder or like a creature coming up out of the shadows, whenever the depression would shrink, it would be something that would be following the person close behind or something just perched on their shoulders. And I really liked this idea because it definitely showed how I was feeling. Even on happy days, I would always feel that cloud of depression nearby. So I thought it would also be a good way to represent my creature or that monster Sona, which I've now called a blight. So yeah, whenever you see my persona with a black eye or with that little slime creature hanging off of it, you'll know what it's called now and why it's there. On the other hand, I've definitely noticed that I have been getting a lot better. While yes, times are still really stressful and my family just got out of a really big problem that we've been having with my stepfather, or ex-stepfather at this point, I definitely wanted to kind of close that chapter that's been hanging around me since high school. Again, I really love this character design, but as I've been going through my whole art career, with big air quotes at the beginning and end of that, I've noticed that Calliope hasn't completely represented me anymore. In high school, a lot of times I would be surrounded by a lot of edgy art from people who are my age, and that being a sharp contrast of black and whites with bright colors, which I still think looks pretty cool, but like I said, it's kind of time to close that chapter. Hence why I've decided to edit Calliope's design with not just the colors, but slightly for her body. Ugh, my throat is already starting to hurt. Since Calliope is made up of three animals that are in some ways similar and in other ways totally different, Well, I picked these characters since I thought it would balance it out with still keeping the general shape that she had before. I kept her overall slender body, which is definitely representative of a cat and the river otter, which, looking at it now, kind of makes it look like she's got little rat feet. But I still really like the way her tail looks, and if you remember from my other video where I drew myself as a unicorn, I definitely like this tail shape for magical or monstrous creatures. Though I tried to make it a little bit thicker to look more like the otter tail, while becoming longer like the cat's tail and ending on long tufts of hair like a horse's tail. And instead of the little ears with the tiny little ear flaps on them, which a lot of people just take as being like tufts of fur instead of like little flappies, and instead gave her horse ears. One thing I find really cute about horses is the fact that their ears rotate. And I'm happy that I made them as round as possible without looking like mouse ears. That way you could definitely tell that they weren't exactly cat ears. Looking back on it, I probably should have given her hooves instead of little rat feet. But considering that she's made out of two predators instead of two herbivores, well, two predators and a herbivore, I thought it would be best for those traits to kind of dominate the other, especially with her having claws and sharp teeth. But I think when it comes on to the fur pattern, it definitely shows part of her horse side. With the colors, I still wanted to give her a kind of lighter palette like I had before, but I wanted it to be more natural colors contrasting with the neon colors that I had before. So, using my Pony Sona as a reference, I used the marking and color scheme for the monster, giving her little gloves and booties, making her hair black with a few white streaks, and it was definitely fun doing the whole paint splatter pattern like before. I really loved the soft cream colors and sort of a chocolatey brown, as well as how her black hair looks with white streaks through it. This little element in her design is actually something that's going on with me physically. I'm starting to get early grays, so I thought it was time to incorporate that permanently into at least my monster design. But I couldn't really give up her striped tail as easily as before, so instead I made it to where her little paint splatter marks kind of twist around her tail, making them look like stripes, but they're actually just one big marking that just twirls around her tail like a lollipop. Or would it be candy cane? Anyways. I'd only planned this to be like a quick forward-facing character design, but I decided to make a full ref sheet because I ended up really enjoying drawing these paint splatter marks. Which, if you haven't guessed by now, is what the whole, is what a paint horse is famous for, and why it's called a paint. I don't do a lot of character reference sheets like this, where I show the back of the character and such, but I'm definitely getting the hang of doing it. Especially since I had always found them really interesting, and wished that I could be able to do that as well. But for some reason, I always thought that it was hand done front to back instead of slightly cheating like how I just showed you. Oh, and quick thing, since you probably couldn't notice from me not letting the picture zoom in and out, her little monster mark that's under her eye, I actually made it to where it sort of looked like paint splatters too. Like it still has that zigzag thing, which, by the way, I referenced off of like 80s rock stars and how they would do their makeup. I made sure to give it little paint splatter marks. That way it fits into her fur pattern. And we're all done. That's the new Calliope. So overall with this, I don't think I really had much of a point to it. I think I mostly wanted to confirm for myself that While I am still the same person that I was in high school, I have changed a bit. Even if it's not totally noticeable. I'm still not much of an adult. I'm still as picky as a toddler. But I guess with this more softer color palette and a design that made a little bit more sense, I guess I just wanted to make a character that was more representative of the current me. Currently, my life isn't perfect, obviously, especially with the state of the world. But compared to high school, I'm definitely a lot happier. I'm not completely happy with my life, but I can say that I am content with it. And before this video ends, I want to thank everybody who's stuck with me as long as they have. This channel has almost reached 2,000 subscribers, and as I've said multiple times before, that's definitely a lot more than I thought I would ever get. I still don't think I can ever make YouTube a career for me, but I still love putting out content for everybody. So, if you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe if you haven't already. And if you could have a monster that was a fusion of three animals, what would those three animals be? Leave it down in a comment below. I absolutely love reading your guys' comments. And if you want to help support me, I have Patreon. But if you can't support me on there, that's totally fine. And with all that said, please be safe out there, wash your hands, and watch out for the monsters under the bed, and I'll see all you jelly beans in the next video. Bye!